Hello and welcome to Daily Tid Video. In this video, we will see how to transfer WhatsApp messages from Android phone to iPhone. If you have tried the Move to iOS app to transfer all the data, you might be noticing that the WhatsApp data alone is missing after you have successfully completed all the data migration from the Android to iPhone. So that's why we need to go for a third-party application. Before proceeding with this tutorial, I must tell you two important things. Number one, this is a paid software. I did try some free softwares and nothing worked as successfully as this one did. So that's why I need to recommend this software to you. And this software comes at the price of $29. We do have a 20% discount coupon, which will help you to buy the software at around $23 to $24. If you really find your WhatsApp data very, very important along with its attachments and you want to transfer everything seamlessly to your new iPhone, then you may consider this software as a worthy one. And the second important thing is I did purchase their Mac software at first. Then I had certain issues like the Android device was not able to connect with my iMac through the software and I had to purchase their Windows software once again. But their tech support was very helpful and very fast in replying to the questions, any technical issues that you face. So I actually explained to them that the software and the troubleshooting steps they have suggested didn't work for me with my Mac computer, with my iMac. So they have issued me the full refund and then I was able to purchase the Windows software and then I proceeded with the process of transferring all the WhatsApp messages with the help of my friend's Windows laptop. So things went really smooth and I'm going to show you the exact process step by step. And if you think I'm going a little bit faster in between the steps, then kindly make a pause and then watch the step and then move it forward. All right, without any delay, let's start with the process. So the dr.fone, this particular software, there is a bundle which will comes around the iOS toolkit, they call it as iOS toolkit, and it comes at $99, which you definitely don't need it. And to complete the task of, you know, transferring all the WhatsApp messages alone to your from your Android phone to iPhone, the $23 or $24 plugin itself is enough. So this is how the software screen actually looks like, and you will see the four box on the center of the page on your Windows computer. And or if you're buying the Mac version, then you will see the same thing. So transfer WhatsApp messages, we are not going to do the transfer directly. First, we need to back up the WhatsApp messages to the local computer hard drive, and then we will be using the third option, which is restoring the WhatsApp messages. And another important thing I must tell you is you can use this software to transfer the WhatsApp messages from an iOS device, iPhone to Android. So in future, if you're planning to do the same, if you're going to switch from iPhone to Android, then you can take all the WhatsApp data back to your Android without any problem. And you can use the same software for with your friends or family members, so you don't find the $23 actually a waste one. So the very first step is backing up all the WhatsApp messages on your Android phone. And before proceeding with this step, make sure you have access to the developer options on your Android phone and completed two important steps to successfully connect the dr.fone software with your Android phone. I'll show the step-by-step process in the left side for the Android phone, and the right side you'll be seeing the process with the iPhone. And so for connecting it, you need to, if your Android phone is not giving you the pop-up to turn on the USB debugging and install via USB options from the developer console, then you need to manually do it. You simply have to follow the step-by-step process that is shown on the screen. You need to go to the settings and then go to the about section and then access the developer options to turn those two functions on. And then as a safety measure, go to your WhatsApp and then settings, then chat backup, and take one backup to your Google Drive just for safety reasons. If anything goes wrong, then you'll have the present data of your WhatsApp on the Google Drive stored safely. You can then restore it. And then as the third process, you need to turn off the auto backup feature to never or only when I tap backup. But you know, I simply set this as a never to take an auto backup. So I simply turned it off. And then go to the settings and scroll to the bottom, go to app permissions or permissions, and then enable storage permissions to WhatsApp, so that it'll be able to store the WhatsApp backup data on your phone first and then transfer it to the computer. So as you can see, by default, it's off in my phone. So I have to turn it on in this step. And once the fourth step is completed, you will see the WhatsApp will be refreshed and it'll be set it up as like a new one. You already have a backup in your Google Drive, so don't worry. So simply set it up with proper OTP and functions, everything, you know. You can simply setting it up like a new WhatsApp account. So when you move with each step, you can see on the computer that the dr.fone WonderShare software is showing you the step-by-step process that involves this particular thing. So you have successfully took a backup of the WhatsApp from the Android phone to the computer. So now we are going to do the third process, which is the WhatsApp messages backup we have taken will be restored to the iOS device, to the iPhone. So as you can see, this is the successful backup and their file size is 1.5 GB. So this is the backup file I have downloaded to the dr.fone software. So I have connected both the phones, both the Android phone and iPhone, to the computer. So you can see that I need to enable the permission to let the computer access the phone storage and the system of the iPhone. So to give trust on that particular prompt. And you can see it has successfully established the connection and it is ready to begin. So in this prompt, you need to select either no, you know, if you are, obviously we are going to set it up as a new iPhone, so I'm going to select it as no. And if you already have some data on your iPhone, then you can select yes, but it will take a little extra time, but you know, it will not erase all the existing data and it will append all the new data to your iPhone. Just for a safety measure, I would say that we need to turn it, select no, and proceed with the fast transfer. And the next step is we need to turn off Find My iPhone to successfully initiate the transfer and complete it. So I have turned it off from my settings iCloud on my iPhone, Find My iPhone, and you can see the process is initiating. It will use the system based built-in restore function in order to successfully restore the WhatsApp backup, that app specific backup to your iPhone. So you can see on the screen that 13% completed. So everything, the progress keeps on moving forward and you will be seeing everything on the screen itself. So the iPhone will be rebooting a couple of times. Don't worry, just wait for the successful reboot and you will see on the screen that the restore is completed. I have just a little bit fast forwarded the entire process. So the backup is done, the restore is done, all the data is there. So on the iPhone, launch the WhatsApp and select simply the chat backup to off. And as you can see, all the data from my Android phone is now transferred to the iPhone successfully. So this is how it works and I hope you found this video useful and this software along with its 20% discount coupon code useful. And this coupon will be good for quite some time. So if it is expired, I'll try to update it as soon as it's available. And if you find this useful, don't forget to share it with your friends and family members. They may also find it useful and carefully they can export their WhatsApp data from their Android phone to iPhone. And if you have any questions or any stuck up in between the steps, you can simply post your question at dailytech.com/answers. I'll be able to respond it to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day.